Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, Excel 2013 Preview, FilterXML, and xPath. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. Now, yesterday, talked about using the equal web service and encode URL, and briefly talked about FilterXML. Now, this example, this is actually from the Excel 2013 help file. They had a nice little web service out here that goes out to xml.weather.yahoo.com and pulls in a certain zip code. First thing that I want to show you is when you have a file and you save the file and close the file and reopen the file, web service functions have automatically been disabled. You're going to have to turn that back on. So it doesn't want it just running out there to the web and pulling in thousands of characters of data, especially if it's going against your web service quota. Okay, so here is where the equal web service is pulling the data back in. And remember yesterday I showed you this great trick. We're going to copy that cell and we're going to come out to Notepad and paste. And we can start to take a look through the various fields here. Now, in the Microsoft example, they had pulled in something called weather location, city and region, something else called weather condition temp and weather condition text, and they had pulled in weather forecast day and weather forecast text. I said, oh, well, let's see what else we have out there. So I'm going to go out and look for this why weather forecast. So we come here to Notepad. So here in Notepad, let's make sure we go to the top because they're fine when it goes in one direction. We'll look for why weather forecast like that. Okay, there we go. And we can start to just take a look at the data that's coming back. So there's the day, that's Tuesday. There's actually a date field, there's a low field, a high field, and then the text field and code. All right, so everything but code, I understand exactly what that means. So we have day and date. So instead of actually getting the day like Tuesday, if I wanted to get the date, I know that I want to change day to date. So let's come back here and take a look at this formula. This is a array formula. So I'll select all those cells and instead of @day, change it to @date. Control shift enter. All right. And then format that as a day. We can even use long date if we wanted. And bam, there we go. So very possible to by taking a look in Notepad, you can figure out the xPath that you need. So the Microsoft example had given us day and text. I copied that example and used low to get the low temperature, high to get the high temperature, and it all seems to be working fairly well. Let's see if we can update this. So there's a new zip code, Merritt Island, Florida, 76 fair, and the weather for the rest of the week. So yet another example of how to use the web service. This time though, taking a look at the filter XML function and how we can, using Notepad, figure out the various fields and pull different data in. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast.